Hello and welcome to another COVID-19 Ministry and Prayer Special. I'm Greg Bogdan here with TLN. You know, TLN is here to challenge believers to live their total life in Christ. You know, we're here for you all the time, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, but especially during this time of global crisis, we're here to encourage you spiritually, meet your spiritual needs. We are not here, by the way, to be all the answers of what's happening with COVID-19 from a news and information update perspective. I would challenge you to tune into your local news or go to the CDC website if you'd like further information about what's happening specifically with COVID across the country and across the world. But we're here to meet your spiritual needs. We want to challenge you to continue to come here each and every day, Monday through Friday. In the Chicago market, we'll be airing special programming 3:30 p.m. Central Time. In the San Francisco market, 1:30 p.m. Pacific Time. And we'll continue to do that throughout this crisis as we're able. The Bible verse for today that we'd like to start with is Psalms 23, verse 4, and it says this: "Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me." We have a special guest here with us today. His name is Dr. Julian Wong Loy Singh. He's pastor of teaching and development at Hickory Creek Church. Pastor, I'm actually going to continue on this scripture for a quick second here. I know they don't have it up on the screen, but it goes on to say, "Prepare a table for me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows." And here's the neat thing: "Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever." You know, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. You know, for many people dealing with this situation today, they may be saying, well, what does that mean for me today? Surely goodness and mercy, how does that work?
Yes. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely.
You know, this is a very well-known passage, and the presence of God has been promised to be there in the most dire of circumstances. So when even the psalmist may have said, you know, in the darkest valley, he may not have imagined a COVID-19 valley.
Right.
And so, but for God, that is unknown. And so his goodness to be present with me, I'm going to have to allow him to define what goodness looks like in and through this darkest valley.
Absolutely.
And that requires trust, and that requires giving up my definitions of goodness and my ideas and framing of goodness, and to let God define what that goodness would look like.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I just want to let you guys, those that are watching, know that as of today, TLN is following all of our government mandates of operation. We're managing social distancing in the office here, and also our studio has less than 10 people. So anything you see that might look a little bit weird, if the lighting isn't quite perfect, which I'm sure it is because our guys are amazing, it's because we're trying to manage all those government mandates. But we want to be here for you. The main reason we want to be here is because we want to be here to pray for you. I know that many of us are struggling with anxiety and depression and angst through this time of COVID-19 and the effects on our lives. CareForce prayer volunteers are here for you, 888-235-9907. They'll be here throughout the show live. Anything you might need to call for, whether it's specific about this COVID-19 situation, or maybe you have other needs, maybe it's a financial situation that has nothing to do with this, but you need God's presence, you need his answers in your life, call us today, 888-235-9907. Well, let's go ahead and go to prayer here in studio as well. And I'd like to start by praying for those who are abroad that may be struggling to get home or don't quite know what to do in their situation as they're not at home with their family.
Let's pray for that. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Father, for the displaced people, not in their country, not at their homes, we pray, Lord, that they would understand what your staff and your rod would mean in this moment. God, that they would see how your staff, a symbol of authority, has authority beyond the borders that they are knowing and they're familiar with. Lord, that your rod, that your comfort would be able to be present even though their surroundings is so unfamiliar, and that which, Lord, they know to lean on, they wouldn't know where to go. God, I ask specifically and especially that your people in that city where there are displaced people overseas caught in this COVID-19 displacement, that your people would be able to rise up identify themselves and be your hands and be your voice and be your agents, Lord, to those others who are displaced. God in heaven, would you calm the fears and the hearts? Would you, Lord, show how you are a good shepherd, even in this dark alley, even, Lord, in this unknown place? Allow, Lord, your people to learn who you are in new ways because of this situation. And we thank you, Lord, that you are on this mission. And we thank you for allowing us to be stretched. We thank you and we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. You know, I can't imagine. I was thinking the other day that, you know, I'm sitting in my home and frustrated because we're kind of stuck, right? And then I realized, I heard a news article where it was talking about the fact that so many of these people that are abroad are in limbo and their hotels are shutting down, the flights are being canceled, and they're truly at a loss of what to do. So yeah. I appreciate you praying for them. And at this point, I'm going to actually pass it over to you. This is my favorite part of the show where I get to hear what God has for you to our audience.
Thank you for having me. Well, for this moment, I want to think about COVID-19 and a Christian response as framing our expressions around the God who doesn't leave himself without a witness. The God who doesn't leave himself without a witness. Now, in order to get there, I'm going to basically say that despite, my theology tells me that despite all that is going on that is negative, I must be able to find something where God is showing up. And that notion is supported in many passages. I'm going to pick a few to just remind you. Philippians 4:8 says, brothers and sisters, finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. And I'm going to include verse 9. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. I'm very certain that you would want the God of peace to be with you. And for the God of peace to be with you, the Apostle Paul in Philippians 4:8-9 says two things need to happen. Your thought patterns need to dwell on virtuous things, virtue, excellence. You have to find the good, the positive. And then the second thing he says is whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, four things. In other words, what I have modeled, practice those things. I'm going to say that during this time, biographies, even the story of your great-grandfather, great-grandmother, even a story of how they've practiced is going to allow the God of peace to be with you. And this may be then a good moment to dig up old pictures in the attic, to go through the material that needs organizing. Why? To try to find the stories of how God has worked in history through his people. But the first part is where I have to put my mind. It says to think about these six items, whatever is true, whatever is pure, whatever is noble, right, lovely, admirable. And so this list is asking us to have a discipline. It's very easy to be passive when the news is keep coming at us that we will not be actions. So in other words, instead of just being a consumer, we have to be a producer. And what is the producer? The producer has to now go produce what is the good that has been coming in through this. What is truth? What is true in here? So these virtues make us active. And you cannot, during a COVID-19, just take words. You have to fact check them. You have to double check them. And that requires skill sets that are going to sharpen you And that is going to allow us to experience the God of peace to be with us. In other words, I'm finding that newscasts are normally like 90% the news, like bad news, and then at the end they'll throw in a good story to just feel good. I think God's witness is not that proportion. I think there is a reason for that proportion. And so try to think, if God is really as big as he is and he doesn't leave himself without witness, and you know where I get that phrase, right? If I had more time, I would take you to Acts chapter 14, one of my favorite passages that actually made me a foodie, you know, for loving a food. Because in Acts chapter 14, you have the apostle Paul and in trouble. And in verse 17, he uses the phrase, yet he has not left himself without testimony. He has shown kindness by giving you rain from heaven and crops in their seasons. He provides you with plenty of food and fills your heart with joy. Even with these words, they had difficulty keeping the crowd from sacrificing to them. You know the story in chapter 14. These people shouted that what Paul had done, that the gods had come down from heaven. And Barnabas, they called Zeus, and Paul, they called Hermes, and they wanted to offer sacrifices to them. And Paul and Barnabas are going, we're not gods. Guess what? Before we came on your scene, God was already on there. In other words, I'm going to prove it to you. Didn't you eat before we get here? Yeah. Well, didn't you eat good food? Think about all the good food you had, says Paul. Then, look, he has shown kindness by giving you rain from heaven and crops in their seasons. He provides you with plenty of food. Guess what? God has not left himself without a testimony. In other words, despite the turmoil and despite the stuff that is happening among us, if God is a living God, he leaves a living track record. He leaves a living hourly second track record. And so this God, who's not left himself without witness, is asking us, could you please notice me in the midst of COVID-19? That the biggest news is not COVID-19, but it is me, Yahweh, who's leaving a witness behind for you. And so I want you not only to know that and not miss that, I want you to actually think on those things. Think on that which is good. Contemplation is necessary, but like we saw in verse 9, contemplation together with action. Contemplation and action, and now do that which I showed you to do, says Paul. And so we go as believers during this time, not just from intaking, but also producing and sharing and allowing others to be infested by the model that is inspired by the goodness of God. This God of peace that wants to be with us wants us to first think on that which is good. You know what I did? I said, all right, let me just start a journal of the good that I'm noticing each and every day. And I have it here with me. And I have the journal based on COVID-19. In other words, God does many good things, but I wanted to see how he does them in COVID-19. So these are things that I gave thanks for. And I know I'm all over the place. Now you're getting to know how Eastern I am, you know, Asian, my last name. Yes, I'm a true Chinese descent in the Caribbean. We have 80 nationalities that are natives. My mother's family is from the Amazon and native Indians. Don't try to figure out who I am, but just get this big picture. Is that in 1 Timothy chapter 2, when God says to Timothy, you put the church on the rails, and a church who's on the rail, the people of God who are on the rail, are a praying type of people. And what do they pray for? They pray for all people. But they do not just praying. We think of praying as requests. It says, with all prayers and thanksgiving. When was the last time you gave thanks
for what you've seen other people do, not even within the church, but outside of the church. Thanksgiving for government officials. Thanksgiving. So I decided to do this journal, and I'm just going to read it to you as far as time allows me to go. These are things, and I have them by the date that they appeared in the news. March 11th, a 103-year-old grandmother has made a full recovery from COVID-19 after being treated for 6 days in Wuhan. The grandmother has become the oldest person to recover from the deadly disease so far, days after a 101-year-old man also beat the virus in Wuhan. And Wuhan was this epicenter. March 12th, first Tulsa COVID-19 patient has recovered, health department says. He has tested negative for the virus twice. The Tulsa Health Department reported two negative tests is the standard indicator for recovery. March 12th. March 13th, Apple reopened all 42 stores in China. March 14th, medical workers in Wuhan reveal smiles behind their mask. By the way, these are taken specifically so you can Google them and find them. After their city closes its last temporary hospitals, 16 temporary hospitals were constructed, and March 14th, closure of the last of the 16. It was panic built to accommodate the overflow of coronavirus present. No more needed. March 15th, a local bivocational missionary in Bologna, Italy, reported that although the church building is closed, their Bible messages via Facebook Live is now reaching more people. Every Sunday, he reached 100 people. On this Sunday, the first one, when they were closed, 600 people watched. One response was from one of his health colleagues. He's bivocational, and he works in the healthcare. And this colleague of his set his whole family down to watch the online service and then gave the missionary positive feedback. The missionary had never had the opportunity to share the good news so directly and openly before. March 16th, first patients given shots of potential coronavirus vaccine in a clinical trial on the West Coast. March 17th, Metro Medical Health in Cleveland can now test COVID-19 sample results in 2 hours. It used to be in days that they gave results. Somebody came up with 2 hours. March 18th, the people in the Philippines are receiving COVID-19 test kits from other countries. Help is coming at a dire time, said Secretary Francisco Duque in a press conference, that we've received 2,000 additional kits from China. 10,000 kits came in from other countries, 500 from South Korea, and 5,000 to 10,000 units arriving in the week. Isn't it beautiful to see the generosity on a worldwide scale? Give thanks, thanksgiving for God, for all people. March 19th, Italy, as you know, is right now, in March 19th, is the epicenter. People, it says, are leaving coffins in the street. They can't bury them fast enough. Instead of one page of obituary, it's 10 pages. Guess what? Cuba sent, March 19th, 53 doctors and nurses to fight COVID in Italy. The team, this is the same team that fought and survived the Ebola virus in 2014 in West Africa. And China sent people, they will be arriving March 21st. Venezuela and an evangelical group of medical doctors arriving March 19th. March 20, this is March 20, good thing. Meals to the needy are going out. Truckers are making long hauls to keep stock up. And this is what happened in the 11 o'clock briefing. I had to write it down. This is what happened. It said this: people who do not like each other are working together and even starting to like each other. And I thank God for that. God is not leaving himself without a witness. He's committed to saying that his goodness pervades despite of the darkest hour.
Amen. Well, you know what? That's really and encouragement, just the idea of giving thanks in the midst of difficulty. You know, it reminded me of Psalm 75, verse 1. We give thanks to you, O God. We give thanks, for your name is near. We recount your wondrous deeds. I mean, how important it is for us to understand as Christians that when we go through trials, to look back and remember that God is there.
Exactly. And what happens is we now have a chance to microbite. And in the microbiting, like, you know, in the word out there, it's like to be mindful. Yeah. Now that you can eat your meal in smaller bites, taste that meal and each bite, thank God. We used to just pray at the beginning of the meal. Yeah. Now you can pray at each bite. Wow, that was a good taste. Mm. Wow, you have a drink of water? Taste that again. Let it slosh around in your mouth. Microbiting into God's goodness allows us to see things that we may have taken for granted before.
Yeah. And I think as Americans especially, and I know around the world, I'm not picking on the rest of the world. I get to just pick on America because I live here. But we take everything for granted. I think we so often don't realize what immense blessings we have. Mm-hmm. You know, and it's really amazing in times like this to say, you know, let's take a step back. Let's look at these blessings. Let's look at all the things God has done through our experiences to show us God is not only sovereign, but he's there for us in those times.
Exactly. And so this is a moment to repent for things that we may have taken for granted in our backyard, in our basements, things we've taken for granted around the house, in the stock that we have. Yeah. So this is a moment for repentance.
Right.
And so to miss out on this moment is to miss out on the God who doesn't want to leave himself without witness.
Yeah. Well, I've got one other point I want to make, but I just want to remind you, if you're watching and you need prayer, call our Care Force prayer line right now, 888-235-9907. We have live operators available to pray with you. You know, I believe there are two different ways to look at our faith, and we as Christians should always be thankful when we see God working in us. But the question we have to ask ourselves are in times like this, do we see God working through us? And I think those are two very different things. I just want to read 2 Peter chapter 1, starting in verse 5. It says, "For this very reason, make every effort to supplement your faith with virtue, and with virtue knowledge, and with knowledge self-control, and self-control with steadfastness, and steadfastness with godliness, and godliness with brotherly love, and brotherly affection with love." You know, as a Christian for many, many years, I think my faith ended at in godliness, right? I was in the scriptures, I was studying, I was excited when God was working in my life, but I never took it to that final level of, okay, now let God work through me.
Yes.
You know, and how can we do that in these times?
And that's where you first have to have that vision that God wants to not work only in you, but through you. And therefore you have to say, God, sorry for limiting you. Now I want to be your agent of love to people that I may not even have thought about.
Yeah.
And so how to do that is to think, Lord, here, what is it that I have in my hand? Start taking stock. Lord, how can I make this available to others? So for example, even with the social distancing, an example that was given was a church can have a person in a car and make scheduled route to come and honk, and you open a window and you just stay in the window in the car, and the person stays in the house and does a wellness check. But it requires you to give up possibly on watching a show. It requires you possibly to just stay passive. You just have to get in your car and go just do wellness checks. That would be an extension of your love. Your love can grow.
Yeah.
I'm not saying people haven't loved before, but now the love muscle it can find new ways of expression.
Yeah, that's powerful. You know, you said, Paul was saying, whatever I have modeled for you, do these things.
Yeah.
You know, in order to be modeling, we have to be moving outside ourselves. We can't be ingesting and taking from God without giving. And if, you know, I pray that my kids someday will look at me and go, Dad, I wanna do all the things that you've modeled for me spiritually. At least the good things.
Yes.
Not the bad things.
Yes. Exactly. And so we realize that we are now an opportunity to be a model of God's witness. So when it says God doesn't want to leave without a witness, he's actually placed beacons all over the countryside, yeah, all over the urban centers of the world, to be able for him to have subwoofers and tweeters. And so I'm looking forward to hearing from your journal or your journal what God has been doing in your world through the COVID-19. And then later it can become like an orchestra of praise to the God who hasn't left himself without witness.
Well, we've got about 3 minutes left. If you wouldn't mind praying in these final moments for our audience, and that they would just be able to find that praise and that thanksgiving in this time.
Let me do that. Thank you. Heavenly Father, I begin with a confession that we may have focused so much on the negative, focused so much, Lord, to the neglect of you scripting a witness for yourself on national level, on state level, on world level, individual level, cross languages. Oh God, forgive us for allowing our vision to be so myopic. Would you expand us, Lord, in this moment to be, Lord, a light we've never been before? Would you allow us, Lord, to be a witness we have not been before? Would you give us courage, O God? Would you allow the models from history that have gone before us, showing how they have been generous during a time where everybody else was selfish? O Lord, will these models inspire us to be able to move beyond us? And so, Lord, would you bring healing during this COVID-19 moment, even in families that are ripped apart from other reasons, God, that they would be able to bury those axes and to be able, Lord, to have a common enemy before them. I ask for mothers who are alienated from daughters and dads who are alienated from sons, that they would feel a rapprochement because, Lord, you're stretching them, the love that you have in them and through them, to be able to reach generations that may have been lost. Father, together with the Christians in China that have asked for a request that more people would come to know Jesus Christ than have lost their life, we ask together in faith, believing that there will be more people coming to a living relationship with Jesus Christ, the one and only way, to be able to say that you have left yourself a witness despite, Lord, of death around us and above us and beyond us. Oh God, that the life that has come up would be a witness, Lord, of your goodness. We thank you that you're allowing us to be living in this moment and to be able to witness in this moment. Hear, Lord, the testimony of our witness. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Dr. J, thank you so much for this encouragement. Let's be reminded, there's always good in every moment if we focus on God. Thank you for joining us. See you next time.